real quick. I know y'all stopped clapping real quick when I got to the stage. I don't know what that was about. I don't know. Aaron, did you name my credits? You didn't name no credits I did? Madden did a movie. I've been to some shit too. I don't think you. Okay, anyway, y'all get the looks off your face because I've been on TV, so you see the name of it. So I did 2 episodes of Cheaters, nigga. I've been on TV. Let y'all make it snow with me. I put it on my resume. It's still TV credit. I'm gonna fuck. I did so wonderful the first episode. They're like, you wanna be on it again? I said, I can do this again. I'm good at this. That's my life. Nigga just got into a car accident. I'm happy to be here. Yeah, no, listen, man, it's cool. Nigga, I was, nigga asked me, did they get totaled? I was pissed. I'm like, nah, nigga, I still gotta pay the car note. I thought they were gonna total this bitch out. You know, the good thing about getting into a car accident, though, is that's the perfect time to handle all. I don't know what that was about. But that's a good time to handle all the problems your car was having when you get into a car accident. You know what I'm saying? They hit my car, they asked me to give a report. They said, so what messed up on your car? I was like, well, when he hit it, my tags flew off. So I was getting ready to pay the registration. I had 2 tickets in the glove compartment. Those were ripped. They were due that day. One in the carpool lane and a handicap. Take care of all this shit. That's what I need. Just had a daughter. Yeah. Nice. I found out when y'all niggas found out. Okay. Nigga, don't clap. Nigga, I found out on Instagram. Nigga. She tagged me in an ultrasound photo. True story. Nigga. Y'all had like 800 something likes. I'm like, damn, my Instagram popping. I didn't even post nothing today. What the fuck is this about? I think it's the dumbest thing in the world. Like, why women do that? Like, take me on TV. Because I need something to add to my resume. I've been perfectly fine being on the board. And they put me on the damn. Yeah, so I sent her a paternity test. Tagged her on Instagram. Picture on nigga. And I found out on Snapchat, the baby is mine. Yeah, man, I'm a single father too, which is crazy. I got a son that's 17, I'm a single father, and I think it's the dumbest thing in the world. How many single fathers? Exactly, because niggas ain't no single fathers. Because women don't let their kids just go be with the father. I think it's the dumbest shit in the world, man. I meet all these men talking about, man, I can't wait to get home, man. I'm trying to see my son. I'm like, yeah, I've been trying to say that shit for years. Like, women, who got kids, first of all? Okay, so no, okay, 2 people, niggas is lying, all these niggas in here. Nobody got not 1 kid. Whether it's yours, or is that niggas, and you ended up at your place, nobody got, come on, man. Let me tell you something, man, like, I even know women, especially black women, we don't let our kids just go live with a father, we don't just give our kids away. That's why I think it's ridiculous that I'm a single father. Because me growing up, I was never able to go to my father's house. You know, black mothers, like, my mom, that was my punishment. My mom, oh, nigga, keep on playing, I'ma send you to your father. I'm like, I was at a crib, and that's my father. Like, I had, like, 2 fails on my report card. My mom was pissed. So I'm like, wait a minute, Chris, hold on, let me see your report card. Okay, wait, you want to be failing P in English? You know what, give me the phone. I'm about to call your father, introduce you to him, and you go with his ass for the weekend, okay? Go to my father's house. That's why I understand why I'm a single father, man. I think it's the dumbest thing in the world. And I just moved back to my son's grandmother's house. Yeah, it's my mama. Okay, cool. Nigga trying to sugarcoat the truth just in case some single women in here. I don't tell women I live at home with my mama. Because that's the end of that conversation. She's like, isn't you irresponsible? I say son's grandmother, because I know it's going to take about 2 to 3 weeks for the shit to register who that is. By that time, I know she done told all her friends about me. And she done called, feel like, girl, I met this guy. He was at Echo's. He's responsible. And he lived at home with his son's grandmother. Wait a minute, bitch, that's his mama. But I like him too much, I can't live. Woman, that's what niggas do. We wait till y'all fall in love before. we bring all the real shit out, about us out. Let's go. We don't give y'all no option. That's what we're supposed to do. Don't think about the women. That's why I don't think my son respect me. 17, man, he don't respect me. And I don't know if it has something to do with us sharing a room or what. Me and this nigga in the same room in bunk beds. He at the top. I'm at the damn bottom. So damn uncomfortable. So this is how you know it's time to get out the house. Anytime your child tell your mama on you, nigga, it's time for you to get your own shit. Let me tell you what happened. True story. My son told me the other day. What happened in my mama's house, you can't walk in the house with your shoes on. You got to take your shoes off. So I was getting ready to leave. I put my shoes on. I realized I forgot the keys upstairs. I'm like, oh, shoot. Hey, Chris, man, I'll be right back. I'm about to run upstairs and get the keys. He was like, ooh. I was like, ooh, what? He was like, hey, you still got your shoes on in the house. I was like, no, I know. I'm just going to run upstairs and get the keys. It's going to take me 2 seconds. He's like, but Granny don't like nobody in the house with their shoes on. But it's gonna take 2 seconds to go run there, I'll be right back. He's like, ain't that kind of like lying going behind the back? I was like, kinda, but it's gonna take me 2 seconds. Can I please just shit going for us, all like all this big stuff, and that's where y'all go wrong. Y'all want me to have big shit like a job, a damn car, all this extravagant stuff. I think it's the dumbest thing in the world. Like, that's why a lot of women are single. Y'all put too much pressure. I don't say, as a woman, I wouldn't say lower your standards when it comes to men, but have some consideration, ladies, okay? Get you a man that has nothing. Add them to your credit cards, co-sign up a car, move a man to your place. Yeah, you need to do that. Because y'all ever heard of the story Build-A-Bear? It's the same shit. Build-A-Nigga. You gotta get up from the ground up and mold him until you to the man you want him to be. Trust me. A nigga that has nothing, ladies, he can offer you a lot of stuff like faithfulness. He's a great listener. Because listen, having a man is better than no man. Yes, it is. It's having a man is better than no man. If y'all don't agree with me, I'm going to explain to you why. Because it's in the Bible, okay? It's in the Bible. Y'all believe in God, don't you, ladies? Okay, now, I want to speak to you because now I feel something in my spirit telling me to speak to each and every one of you women in here tonight. It's in the Bible. Because when y'all pray to ask God for something, you know God wants you to be specific in what you pray to ask him for, right? You gotta be specific. Like, listen, ladies, you can ask God for a car all day long. And guess what? He has sent you that car. But guess what? It ain't gonna have no engine. You know why? You didn't pray for a running car. It's the same thing when you asking God for a man. You gotta be specific in the man that you ask him for. You gotta say, listen, God, send me a man that's about 6'5", 6'6". Send me a man that has great credit. Send me a man that's brown skin. Send me a man that looks like Chris. Send me a man that love all seven of my kids like he loves you, Lord. And after you finish praying and asking God for that man, ladies, what do you say at the end of that prayer? Amen. There it is. Amen is better than no man. It's better than the Bible. You know what I wish women to stop doing? Stop insulting a man and compliment him at the the same time. Women do that too. And fellas can vouch for me. I say that because I had a girl yesterday tell me I was low-key cute. What the fuck is that? Secret, okay? I get your number right now. I need to be your screensaver, ma'am. You faded it, you need to make me your screensaver tonight and tell the world about me. I meet a lot of grown women, man. I meet a lot of women that live in the hood, too. And I think this is the dumbest thing in the world. I don't care if you live in the hood, women. The only thing about living in the hood is just let a man know. Because women don't tell you they live in the hood until you're all the way to their damn house. Every woman that live in the hood got the same excuse. This is what they say. Fellas, can vouch for me for this. Every woman that live in the hood, this is what they say. They say, it's quiet on my street. I ain't never heard nothing over here. I got the same as Section 8 off of Main. Ain't nothing ever happened over there. Now, around the corner, they be killing on the regular, but I got the same as Section 8. Before I get out of here, I will say this, because this is my time. Before I get out of here, I will say this. As a black man, I am a commodity, and I'm what every woman in here should be. I will say that right now. It has nothing to do with me telling jokes. It has nothing to do with me being low-key cute, living with my son's grandmother. It has nothing to do with that. I'm going to tell you why I'm what every woman should be. It's because I have a job, okay? All right? And I don't just have a normal job. I have a job where I receive free health care, and I can add any woman in here to my benefits, okay? And the co-pays will only be $5, meaning you get a passport and a mammogram, and it's still afford these two drinks over here, okay? Listen, I work at a hospital. I can't tell you which hospital because it's a HIPAA violation. Y'all know what HIPAA is?
Yeah.
Okay, some of y'all know. If you don't in school, you probably on Medi-Cal, but that's your business. But I check in patients. I work in a little pediatric department, a little children's department. And what I will say, my people, black parents, let's start bringing our kids to the doctor. We don't want to bring our kids to the doctor like that. For real, like my mom didn't bring me to the doctor. My mom for the South, she believed in gargling warm salt water no matter what the fuck was wrong with her. That was my mom. Anybody ever done that? You got a sore throat, what would you do? Gargle with some warm salt water. Like, I was having relationship issues. My mom said, both of y'all get in here. Gargle with this warm salt water. Go back outside and pray about it. That was my mom. So working in the hospital, I know there's different nationalities, treat their kids different. Latinos, I love them. Because Latinos are the most supportive group of parents I've ever seen. They bring their kids to the doctor. It'd be about 57 family members bringing one damn child to the doctor's visit. And Latinos, they don't even know what's wrong with the child. This Hispanic father came in the other day. I was like, what's wrong with the child? He was like, I don't know, but my baby's been coughing for like 1, 2, 3 years now. I fear it is time. But it was like a quinceañera in there. It was a whole family of them. White people, I see y'all back there. I love y'all. White people are the most emotional group of parents I ever fucking seen. White parents, they have more pain than the child that they bring in. It's fucking crazy. This white mother came in the other day crying. Oh my God, excuse me, sir. Is this urgent care? I said, yes, ma'am. This is urgent care. What's wrong with your child? My baby sneezed today. I was like, once? She said, yes. I said, you have a $5 copay. She said, here's $100. I said, wow. White parents care. Black parents totally different. And I'm gone. This black mother came in just like this. I'm not making this up. This is how she brought a child. She was like, okay, man, so is that an earache? I don't know what it is, but he's been on that old iPhone all day, and the ear must not be hurting that damn bad. Okay, man, so it'll be a $5 copay. $5? Okay, what does that come with, sir? Man, that comes to see the doctor, that's for the doctor's visit. Okay, well, you need to bill his father. He only see him every other weekend. He on his plan anyway. I'm like, man, we don't build anymore. She was like, well, how am I supposed to fix my baby's ears, sir? I said, ma'am, calm down. Just gargle with this warm salt.